God bless you, everyone. Samantha here. I pray all is well with you. Today, I'm going to continue sharing based on Ephesians 1, but 1a, part A of that verse. I'm going to say a word of prayer before I share what's on my heart. So, Father, I ask that in the name of Jesus, that you can continue to give us wisdom and revelation and the knowledge of you. I pray that you continue to open the eyes of our understanding to be enlightened, that we may know what is the hope of your calling and what are the riches of the glory of your inheritance in the saints, and what is the exceeding greatness of your power towards us who believe, according to the working of your mighty power, which you worked in Christ Jesus when you raised him from the dead and set him on your right hand in heavenly places, far above all principality and power and might and dominion, and every name that is named, not only in this world, but also that which is to come. You have put all things under his feet, and you gave him to be the head over all things to the church, which is his body, the fullness of him who fits all in all. Father, thank you for your word. I thank you, Lord God, that we will not just be hearers of your word, but do us also that, Lord God, this word that you share through me, that it will be written deeply in our hearts. And yeah, Lord God, that you would get the glory as we live it and apply it. In Jesus' name, we thank you for the Holy Spirit, who leads us and guides us in all truth, and and who empowers us to live for you. In Jesus' name, I ask and pray. Thank you, Lord. Amen. So, Ephesians 1:1, I'm going to read it again. Paul, an apostle of Jesus Christ, by the will of God, to the saints who are at Ephesus and to the faithful in Christ Jesus. So last week when I read this, it was on my heart to share that it was the will of God. The will of God for Paul to be an apostle of Jesus Christ. And the Lord has been ministering to my heart about the calling, his calling. And I wrote down some notes here. We do not call ourselves. We do not call ourselves. And this is vital because we fall short to the glory of God every day. And we all have a history. And based on some of the things that some of us have done in the past, you know, human logic will say, who are you to preach, or who are you to teach the word of God, or who are you to do this, and who are you to do that, based on the past? But you know, we are a new creation in Christ Jesus, and God, he died for us while we were yet sinners, while we were in sin. He didn't wait till we got ourselves together and then said, okay, now. No, it's while we were dead in sins. With that being said, the call of God and the gifts of God are based on his purpose. It's not based on our past or what we think we can and cannot do, or what people think we can and cannot do, or people's opinion of us. And God is so good because he's been ministering to me about this for a while, and putting on my heart to read the book of Ephesians and share verse by verse. And today he just kind of like, he said, like, I'm going to confirm this to you. Like, I want you to share on your YouTube channel, whoever sees it will see it, that the call of God is not based on your past. It is based on God. He's the giver of gifts. We can't say, oh, I'm going to give myself this gift. I'm talking about spiritual gifts. Oh, I'm going to give myself this call. When you look at Paul the Apostle's life, and I believe at some point God is going to have us look at that. He's going to have me share something about that. But if you know anything about Paul the Apostle, several Christians do know his history. He was Saul before he was Paul. God actually changed his name. But he was a persecutor of the church. Oh my goodness. he was getting letters to get Christians killed and to harm them. And God called him to minister the gospel of Jesus Christ. And you know, he wrote several of the New Testament books. I mean, he was sent to the Gentiles. Somebody would have said, who is he to even be an apostle after what he did to the church? Now you're going to be in a founding role and you were actually persecuting the church? But he was persecuting Christ, because even when he met God, confronted him on Damascus, on a Damascus road, God said to him, why persecute? Jesus said, why persecute me? So even though he was going after the Christians, God saw it, Jesus saw it as persecuting him. Why am I saying this? Based on Paul's past, he had human logic would say, no, he can't be no apostle. But Paul, an apostle of Jesus Christ by the will of God. So we can look at our own lives and say, you know what? We can see God's promises and how God does some things by reading this verse here. Oh, wait a minute. If God tells me I'm to do this, I'm to do that, this is what he's called me to, let me get out of the past. Let me not have a mindset that because of my past or my struggles or what people think of me, I can't do what God is calling me to do. No. So we're shutting that down right now. And, you know, we can hear this, but it takes the Holy Ghost to work this in us, to get us up out of ourselves, to get us up out of our past, to look to God and say, okay, God, I'm going to go in your strength. I'm going to go according to your word. I'm going to obey and do what you say do based on you. Nothing else. Nothing else. No one, no other voice, no past, no struggle. No, I give all of that to you, and I'm going to go and run with the vision that you've given me, the call. I'm going to walk worthy of the vocation wherewith you have called me, God. So with that being said, it's on my heart to read about some gifts. And so first of all, okay, we do not call ourselves, and the Spirit gives gifts. Now, apostleship is a gift. It's a gift, right? Some argue that it's no longer in operation. I don't know what Bible they're reading, and I don't want to go into all that, but I'm going to just stick with the Word of God, because Ephesians was written after the ascension of Christ, and Paul definitely was after the ascension of Christ. He was appointed, and God had him write something in the book of Ephesians. So I'm going to read that, Ephesians 4. Oh, matter of fact, before I read that, thank you, Lord, I also want to go to Galatians 1:1. From my heart, let me read that real quick. Galatians 1:1. Okay, it says, Paul, an apostle, not of men, nor by man, but by Jesus Christ and God the Father, who raised him from the dead. Paul, an apostle, not of men, nor by man, but by Jesus Christ and God the Father, who raised him from the dead. Galatians 1:1. Okay, now let's go to Ephesians 4. And we're going to start reading from 1 through 16. Okay, here it goes. I, therefore, the prisoner of the Lord, beseech you to walk worthy of the vocation to which you are called, with all lowliness and meekness, with long suffering, forbearing one another in love, endeavoring to keep the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. There is one body and one Spirit, even as you are called, and one hope of your calling. One Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is above all and through all and in you all. But to every one of us is given grace according to the measure of the gift of Christ. Therefore, he says, when he ascended on high, he led captivity captive and gave gifts to men. This is what Jesus did. He gave gifts to men. We cannot erase that out of Scripture. Now that he ascended, what is it but that he also descended? First, into the lower parts of the earth. He who descended is the same also who ascended far above all heavens, that he might fill all things. And he gave some apostles and some prophets and some evangelists and some pastors and teachers for the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ, until we all come to the unity of the faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God, to a perfect man, to the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ, that we from now on will no longer be children tossed to and fro and carried about by every wind of doctrine, by the deception of men in cunning craftiness, by which they lie in wait to deceive, but speaking the truth in love, may grow up in all things into him who is the head, even Christ, from whom the whole body, properly joined together and compacted by what every joint supplies, according to the effectual working in the measure of every part, increases the body for the edifying of itself in love. So in this passage, at the latter end, it shares the gifts that Jesus gave and why he gave them. But there's no denying that he gave gifts, okay? Also, it's in my heart to read 1 Corinthians 12. And there's also more gifts in Romans, which I didn't write down here, but maybe the Lord will have me to read it, or maybe next time. But today, I'm just praying to stay on track with what he wants me to share and not be all over the place. Okay, let's see. So, spiritual gifts in the body of Christ. So this is 1 Corinthians 12, and I'm starting at verse 1, and I'm going to read through to 11. Now concerning spiritual gifts, brothers, I will not have you ignorant. You know that you were Gentiles carried away to these mute idols, even as you were led. Therefore, I want you to understand that no man speaking by the Spirit of God calls Jesus accursed, and that no man can say that Jesus is Lord but by the Holy Spirit. Now there are diversities of gifts, but the same Spirit. And there are differences of administrations, but the same Lord. And there are diversities of operations, but it is the same God who works all in all. But the evidence of the Spirit is given to every man to profit with it. For to one is given the word of wisdom by the Spirit, to another the word of knowledge by the same Spirit, to another faith by the same Spirit, to another the gifts of healing by the same Spirit, to another the workings of miracles, to another prophecy, to another discerning of spirits, to another various kinds of tongues, to another the interpretation of tongues. But one and the very same Spirit works all these, distributing to each man separately as he wills. It's as the Spirit of God wills. God in the third person. This is not us calling ourselves. This is not us gifting ourselves. This is all the purpose and the plan and the will of God for a greater purpose far beyond our personal lives. This is about Jesus. This is kingdom building business. And my prayer for all of us in the body of Christ, myself included, of course, right? Because yeah, I'm saying I'm gonna pray for the body. I'm part of the body, so this doesn't exempt me. Like, oh, I've arrived in my thing, because the enemy tries to come after me too with the foolishness, or people say, who are you to say this, or who are you to say that, or when you have to bring a word of correction. Let me tell you, it could even be that God gave you a word. Suppose God gave you a word of knowledge for a family member or your child, and you've struggled with something in the past, and I'm trying to give an example, like in everyday life, because this is not just for when you're in church or when you are a pastor or a preacher or it can be something as simple as in your own home. So you see your child doing something that's wrong, and you remember when you were young what you did. Of course, you're going to be gracious and merciful and kind and compassionate. But that doesn't mean that because you had the same similar struggle, then you don't open up your mouth and give a correction. You just have to do it with meekness and say God and speak the truth in love. But here comes the enemy. Who are you to say something? Because when you were young, didn't you do X, Y, and Z? Now look at you, you hypocrite. The devil is a liar. And the father of all lies. And he will even put that in the mouths of people that know your pastor. Say, how's she going to preach? Or how she going to say something? Didn't she do X, Y, and Z? Yes, I did. But God delivered. And when he delivers us and gets us out of the muck and mire, he does not expect us to sit idly by and see people that we love on the grease pole to hell and not tell them about Jesus. Or if it's a Christian, snatch them out of the fire. Like, look, brother, sister, friend, I love you. The Lord said, this is not what he would have us to do. This is bondage. This is of the enemy. But, oh, your child, like, listen, go sit down. Like, oh, you did it too. Slam the door. What? I'll take the door off the hinges. Now, you need to go. Because God, this is not what he wants for you. You know, but you're going to go slam the door and throw up in my face what I did. That's a no-no. That's a no-no, but the enemy will use that to try to, like, you know, silence us. Who are you to say something? But you are called to speak the word of God. You are, in however he leads you to, you are called to share Jesus. You are called to live for Jesus. And these gifts that we read about, we got to say, God, what is my gifting? Because we can't take on a gift for ourselves and say, that's the gift I want. Because it says, he gives, it says, but one in the very same spirit works all these, distributing to each man separately as he wills, right? So it's like, okay, God, what am I called to? We know some general things that we all called to, which is to share the gospel of Jesus Christ as disciples of Christ. That's what we are all called to live for the Lord, live a consecrated life. There's some general things. But when it comes to the spiritual gifts or the capacity to function, whether we're going to be in a marketplace or what God has called us to do in our local fellowships or, you know, ministry, whatever, God is... He has specifics for all of it. You know, you can even ask God, what school do you want me to go to if he's calling you to an occupation in the marketplace, right? And saying, God, like, what are my spiritual gifts, right? So I pray that encourages you. We do not call ourselves and we do not gift ourselves. God calls us. He gave us a vocation. We need to seek him on what that is and what are our gifts, because the Spirit is the one, God in the third person, that gives us the gifts as he wills. Jesus also gave gifts to God in the second person, the all God, Father, Son, Holy Ghost, God in one, the Trinity. Jesus gave gifts when he ascended, right? Prophets, apostles, pastors, teachers, evangelists. And then there's the administrative gifts. So in Romans, let me see. I think I need to go there. All right, Lord, let me Okay. Okay, Jesus. Let's see. Gifts. Romans. Thank you, Lord. Romans 12. Yes, let me go there. Thank you, Lord. Okay, Jesus. Romans chapter 12. Romans chapter 12. And we're going to start from... Okay, let's see. Let's see. Where did it start from? Start from verse 6. Okay. It says, starting from verse 6, we have differing gifts according to the grace that is given to us. Whether prophecy, let us prophesy according to the proportion of faith. Or ministry, let us attend to our ministering. Or he who teaches on teaching. Or he who exhorts on exhortation. He who gives, let him do it with simplicity. He who rules, with diligence. He who shows mercy, with cheerfulness. And that's Romans 6 through 8. And that's specifically on the differing of gifts according to the grace that is given to us, you know, from God. So I pray that blesses you. That really blessed me. It really, 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 really blessed me. The preacher always, the preacher and the teacher hear it first. It comes out of our mouth. We hear it. Our ears is what's closest to our mouth, and we hear it. And then, you know, whoever hears it too. And thank God, thank God, thank God. Father, thank you for your word. Thank you, Lord God, for the call on our lives, for choosing us, Lord God. And Lord God, thank you for the gifts that you bestowed upon us. Lord God, I not only pray for myself, for those and all of us in the body of Christ, near and far, people that are watching, those that are to come in the fold, that you will continue to develop us. Those of us that don't know our call are kind of unclear, that you would clarify it, make it known, and clarify those that need confirmation, because maybe you've given another gift and our season has changed and there's a shift and we may not be too clear on what it is we're doing now. Pray for clarity in that area, and that we would know the gifts that you have bestowed upon us, and that you will show us how to operate in that gifts, how to yield to you in those gifts, and Lord God, and how you want to develop those gifts in us and teach us about those gifts. And it's for the work of the ministry, the edifying of the body of Christ. It's for your kingdom, for your glory. And we just submit it back into your hands and say, God, have your way. Use us as you see fit. And we thank you and we praise you. In Jesus' name, I ask and pray. Amen and amen. Alrighty, God bless you. Jesus loves you. And if the Lord leads, I'll come back on and continue to share from Ephesians 1. I believe the Lord's going to have me share something about Paul the Apostle, because I believe that's going to give us some encouragement. And then there's a latter part of Ephesians 1, which is 1b. There's another part of that. And I just believe God is just saying, just take your time and share. And don't worry about getting to the end of the book, but just to share as he would have me to share, which I believe is verse upon verse. But you know, God, he gives us a glimpse, and it could be verse by verse, and then he'll have me do 3 verses next month. I don't know. I'm just going to take one step at a time and just obey what I hear him say to do the next step today. Okay, so with that being said, God bless you, and remember, Jesus loves you. All right, later.